Now, the expert, Dr. Kevin Cannard, is a neurologist who actually specializes in movement disorders and also recently published a paper on Parkinson's. And the reason why we're learning about this now is because there are, you know, White House logs that are made public, not immediately, but these White House logs that were finally released by the White House document these visits between July of last year, 2023, through March of this year. More recent visits, if there have been more recent visits by this Parkinson's expert, would not be released until later under the White House's voluntary disclosure policy. Now, Biden also allegedly went or underwent his most recent annual physical checkup at Walter Reed earlier this year on February 28th. And the issue with this Parkinson's expert visiting the Biden White House is we still have many questions. Was he visiting Biden specifically? What were the results of those visits? And so understandably, Cenk, reporters have a lot of questions about this. And so when the White House press secretary, Karine Jean-Pierre, was holding a press conference today, several of the reporters asked about it. And she didn't really seem to take kindly to the line of questioning. So let's take a look at the first clip.
A very basic direct question.
Wait a second.
Eight times, or at least once, in regards to the president specifically.
Hold on a second.
How much you should be able to answer by this point.
Wait, no. No, wait a minute. Ed, please, a little respect here, please. So every year, around the president's physical examination, he sees a neurologist. That's three times, right? So I am telling you that he has seen or a neurologist three times while he has been in this presidency. That's what I'm saying. I am telling you that he has seen them three times. That is what I'm sharing with you, right? So every time he has a physical, he has had to see a neurologist. So that is answering that question.
No, it's not.
No, it is. It is. You're asking me.
I cannot.
But I just. I also said to you, Ed. I also said to you, for security reasons, we cannot share names. We cannot share names.
Listen, we cannot share names is like such a bold-faced lie, okay? Yeah. Insane, because the name is already public. The doctor's name, the Parkinson's expert, his name is already public, Dr. Kevin Cannard. Thanks for watching. Our audience has helped build TYT into the media giant it is today. Together, we can accomplish anything. Support our work and join us at tyt.com/team.
To be fair, and it's not much of anything, but she could be saying, look, he sees a different neurologist and Dr. Cannard is the Parkinson's expert who's coming to the White House. But even so, why is that a state secret? Why is that a security thing? So for example, when Donald Trump was being seen by the doctor or President Obama, they were seen by the same guy, the candy man. So the guy who's a congressman from Texas now, Jackson, right? Mm-hmm. Ronnie Jackson. Who Donald Trump called Ronnie Johnson recently while trying to prove that he doesn't have dementia. Anyway, so was that a security problem? Because we knew the Candyman's name and we even knew his nickname and we even know that he peddled all these pills at the White House? Okay. No, none of that was a security. It's total BS. I'm gonna get back to the BS on the Parkinson's excuse.
Cenk, all of it is BS. First of all, the reporter is specifically asking about the Parkinson's expert, okay? And she's trying to deflect by talking about the yearly physical exam that Biden undergoes. And as part of that yearly physical exam, he has to see a neurologist. You wanna know something? We know the name of the neurologist, okay? His name is Dr. O'Connell. Like I said, the last time he did a physical neurological exam, I guess, on Biden was February 28th. Allegedly, that yielded no findings which would be consistent with Parkinson's, stroke, or other central neurological disorders.
I flat out don't believe them.
I have to be honest, I don't either. Mainly because when Biden was asked during that recent interview with George Stephanopoulos, would you be willing to take a neurological exam? Biden was unwilling to do it. Why are you unwilling to do it if that neurological exam could potentially put all of these concerns to rest?
Yeah, and I'll give more detail on that too. Look, normally with mainstream politicians and mainstream media, when they're trying to deceive you, they don't flat out lie. What they do is they frame it in a different way. So like she's framing it with, well, he saw a neurologist not answering about the Parkinson's.
Right.
In Biden's case, I think they're such bold-faced liars that I think we have no idea what those doctors actually told him at his physical. I think there's an excellent chance they're just flat out making up what the doctor said, or if he even saw a neurologist. That's why the name of the Parkinson's expert is public, the name of his physical, the guy who gives him the physical is public. Mm-hmm. And they're claiming there's a secret neurologist that he sees, and that they're not gonna tell you that name. It's nonsense, total nonsense. And I don't believe he passed a single test. I don't believe he took a single test, okay? And in fact, they've never ever said that he took a cognitive test. So they just keep giving you word salads to try to hide this from you. Okay, guys, so now let's break down Parkinson's for a second. So this guy comes in 8 times in 8 months. Does someone else at the White House have Parkinson's? Does Kamala Harris or the First Lady have Parkinson's? Why is the Parkinson's expert coming in nonstop? Look, it's not impossible. They might have needed him for some other reason. So this guy's been around for a long time. Most years, he comes to the White House 0 or 1 times. But there was 1 year where he came 4 times, another year in 2012 he came 10 times. So it's not impossible, maybe you're asking for expertise, etc. But it's certainly strange under the circumstances. Okay, then you go to second point here. Look, I get that Biden is embarrassed about taking a dementia test. Now, under normal circumstances, you shouldn't be embarrassed at all. There's nothing you could do about it. It is what it is, and you gotta get help as soon as you can. Don't be embarrassed about taking a test. That's ridiculous. But he's in politics, he's in this situation, I get it. But an examination, a clinical examination by an expert for Parkinson's, what could possibly be wrong with that? That's like saying, no, I don't wanna find out if I have cancer. Why don't you want to find out if you have Parkinson's or not? Wait, do you know something we don't know? Because let's say I was running for office, right? And they said, okay, Cenk, we're worried that you have Parkinson's. Do you want to take the test? I'd be like, immediately bring in a doctor. Because why? Why would I have Parkinson's? And if I do, I shouldn't run. It's easy, if they asked you, easy, super easy to say yes to a Parkinson's test. But he won't. Because he either already knows he has it, or they're worried to death that he has it and want to avoid any kind of clinical examination by hook or by crook.
Yeah, look, this is not, first of all, it makes me feel sick to have to be put in a situation where we're speculating about the potential medical concerns of the man running against Donald Trump and the current president, by the way. And Cenk, as you were mentioning, hey, is there someone else in the White House that could potentially have Parkinson's? My mind went through his cabinet. And I remember, you know, Secretary of Defense, I believe it is, or yeah, Lloyd Austin had some health concerns, but that was prostate cancer, obviously very different from Parkinson's. So yeah, I mean, people have questions and we should have those questions answered. And Karine Jean-Pierre getting super snippy with reporters, asking legitimate questions and telling them to be respectful. What do you mean be respectful? You be respectful. You're supposed to answer questions from the reporters. Instead, she speaks down to them and makes them out to be the crazy people for being concerned that the current president of the United States and the person running against Donald Trump, someone that they fearmonger about incessantly, someone they claim is gonna destroy our democracy, people are worried that Biden is gonna be unable to beat him. So you have to answer to that.
And guys, this is the same playbook they used with Dianne Feinstein.
Yes.
Remember, until the very end, they all pretended, no, there's nothing wrong with Dianne Feinstein. No, she can serve as senator, no problem. I mean, don't mind Nancy Pelosi's daughter wheeling her around and telling you what her opinion is. Don't mind the fact that she can't even speak, or when she does, she repeats things over and over because she forgets everything. But don't believe your lying eyes or your ears. That's what they told us about Feinstein. They're now telling us about Biden. This is sick. It's elder abuse. It's disgusting. And at this point, Joe Biden has no credibility. And his main talking point on the campaign trail is what a liar Donald Trump is. That is absolutely true. But now nobody's listening because you're the one telling the biggest lie at this moment. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.